destiny.
Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. So for today's video, as you can tell by the thumbnail, the title of this video, as well as the introduction, I will be blow drying my hair for the first time in a really long time. So I'm starting off on really clean, freshly washed, detangled, deep conditioned hair. You need to start off on a good state, and what you're gonna need is an ultra scrunchie, your heat protectant, a blow dryer, preferably one with an attachment and has different settings. You're gonna need a white tooth comb, and that's pretty much it. So I'm just gonna be sectioning off my hair, even though it's in twists. If you're curious why it's in twists, it's because of my wash day routine. If you want to see how I wash my hair and how I end up to this point, then check out the rest of my videos on my channel. So I'm just gonna be starting off on a really on this section, okay, the back section. So I'm just gonna unravel the twists, and as I said, it's detangled. But what I like to do, guys, especially when I'm stretching out my hair using the blow dryer, obviously you're gonna need some heat protectant. I drenched my hair in heat protectant, guys, because I'm not playing, okay? I'm not playing with that heat damage stuff. No, we're not doing that. So I'm just going to detangle my hair with the white tooth comb just for reinforcement, but my hair is pretty much detangled. It doesn't really need this step, but anyway. So the way I will be blow drying my hair is using the tension method. So the tension method is basically you holding or tugging your hair downward while rubbing, well not rubbing, while running the blow dryer up and down your hair shaft. Now this will help you to give your hair that stretch on both sides of your hair, and it honestly it's the best method in my opinion, because you don't really have much work to do afterwards because it's pretty much stretched after you're finished. So I'll show you guys in a few minutes what I'm talking about. As you can see, like right now, as I am blow drying my hair downward and just not combing my hair through, just blowing the blow dryer down on my hair is pretty much stretched. So I don't really have a lot of detangling to do because, see, I don't have a lot to do. Look at the length, guys. Look at the length, okay? I'm really proud. I'm really proud of my hair. I'm really proud of how far I came, because y'all know where I came from. But anyway, so this is what I'm doing. And it's really important to get a blow dryer with an attachment on it, because this helps even distribution of the hot air on your hair shaft. You don't want too much hot air on just one spot, because that increases your chance of getting heat damage, and we don't need that. So make sure that you have a attachment to it. Like, look at my hair, guys. The blow dryer did not do any justice to my hair because my hair is still longer than what the camera is showing. But anywho, I'm basically doing the same step. Honestly, I love the health of my hair. My hair looks so healthy. Oh my gosh, it looks so healthy. And guys, make sure that when you're blow drying your hair, make sure it's on a day that you don't have nothing to do. So make sure that you schedule that day just for you and your hair, because trust me, especially if you have a lot of hair and you're maintaining your healthy hair, it's gonna take a while, okay? So make sure that you have the mental strength to prepare to do this, okay? Because trust me, it took some time. Okay, I'm not gonna lie, it took some time. I love the way my hair looks, especially the ends. This is how you know that you have healthy hair. The ends of my hair is still full. And I did recently do a trim. I did not record it, but you know, that's how you can tell that you have really healthy hair. Excuse the baby sound in the background. Okay, that's my neighbors. But anyway, so I'm just basically doing the same steps, drenching my hair with heat protectant. I will leave all the tools in the description box below if you're interested. I think this is 45 degrees. This heat protectant can protect your hair up to 45 degrees of heat. So yeah, this is basically all that I will be doing, guys. It's pretty much repetitive, basically the same thing, and I can't keep saying the same things over and over. Oh, but before I go, guys, like, I want to show you a clear example of stretch hair versus shrinkage hair. Like, look at that, look at that. And my hair wasn't even like flat iron stretch, because as you guys can see, even though I blow dried my hair, I still had more length to show. guys, this is what my hair is looking like so far. Even though I'm still detangling it, guys, make sure that you use a lot of heat protectant, okay? Don't blow dry your hair, apply any type of heat on your hair without a heat protectant. Don't do it. So yeah, as I was saying, I'm just still detangling my hair, and I'll show you guys in a sec what my hair is looking like. Honestly, this blow dryer didn't do much justice for my hair because I still had a lot more length to show. But I really hope you guys enjoyed this video, and if you did, don't forget to give me a big thumbs up, subscribe down below, let me know if this video helped you in any way, and until next time, guys, bye.